and Bruins, Philadelphia Flyers, debating for the top spot in the Eastern Conference, battling out in the matinee today. What happens? We will find out. Welcome to Boston Bruins Post Game Recap.
Horton, the drive, score! The Bruins knock out Montreal!
Campbell, it's off by an incredible throw for the first time in 19 years.
The first line, through one, and
score! In front of him, Marchand, a rush shot, and he scores! Brad Marchand for the empty net goal, and a 4-0 lead for the Bruins with 2-4. Get the duck boats ready. After 39 long years, the cup is back home. The Bruins are 2011 Stanley Cup.
Duck has a sizable reach advantage here. Pounds him twice with the right.
The Habs find the coach. Woo! But there's a downside. Montreal hired an interim immediately after they fired coach. So, yeah. 6 coach firings a season in the NHL. So, but Bruins Flyers today on the road at the Wells Fargo Center in Philadelphia. The Bruins, Tim Thomas faced off, was going up against Philadelphia's, whatever his name is. His last name is Galva or something like that. Can't pronounce it right, so. Yeah, let me just say this. Awesome Bruins win. And you'll see how it happened. So, but what are you about? Bruins, 27 seconds into the game. Bruins went up 1-0, 27 seconds into the game by Benoit Pouliot.
For Pouliot, he scores! The Bruins score 27 seconds into it with some tremendous puck movement and Pouliot driving the net.
Boston goal scorer number 67, Benoit Pouliot, assisted by number 47, Rich Peverly, at 27 seconds into the first period, even strength, 1-0 lead for the Bruins. And the 5th goal in the season for Benoit Pouliot and the 16th assist for Rich Peverly. Woo! May I please have the 1,994 Flyers fans leave the Wells Fargo Center. Thank you. Yeah. Well, they didn't really say that. For 1,994 Flyers fans to leave when the Bruins. I'm watching this replay on TV right now, but okay, I don't know why I'm seeing no title, but I can't show my face, so audio is key here. But what that basically meant is that Benoit Pouliot scored 27 seconds into the game, assisted by Rich Peverly at 2:13 of the first period. Dano Chara fought Jody Shelley, and they each got 5-minute majors, and it is not a manpower, and of course it's not a manpower penalty. So then not long after, in fact it took just like 30 or 40 seconds for this to happen, but then Paye scored for the, Daniel Paye, in case you didn't hear already, he returned, but Paye scored to put the Bruins up 2-0 within not even 5 minutes in.
Fargo off a 50-foot rebound. Seinberg to Paye on the rebound, and the Bruins are up 2-0. The Bruins saw Brizgalov give up a ton of rebounds on opening night, and so it is again in the early going here.
And that counts for Paye's third goal in 2 games. And that is his sixth on the season, assisted by Dennis Seidenberg. Seidenberg's 7th assist on the season, as well as Joe Corvo, that with his 12th assist on the season, 2 minutes and 50 seconds into the game, and the Bees are up 2-0. Woo! So then 5:52 in. Philadelphia goes on the power play. by way of Joe Corbo getting a 2-minute interference penalty. But then, not long after, 7:59 into the game, Philadelphia got a too many men on the ice, and two little men on the bench. Yeah, as the box score says, it was for the entire team. It was served by Philadelphia's Zach Ronaldo, the penalty. And look here. And 9 seconds into it, the Bruins score, and the Bees are up 3-0. Woo! That was by Zdeno Chara after the fight he got into. He now has to have an assist for a Gordie Howe hat trick. Woo! So, yeah, that's a little obvious if you didn't know what the Gordie Howe hat trick is. Look it up on Google. Google is your best friend in this scenario. And power play goal. It was assisted by David Krejci with his 13th assist on the season, and Rich Peverly, second assist on the night, 17th on the season, and it was Charles' 7th goal.
To go. Zach Ronaldo is in the penalty box. The power play brought to you by Boston.com. Chara and Peverly out high. Krejci will set up on the boards. Chara scores! A blast from out high. It might have changed direction on the way through, but the Bruins are up 3-0 on Philadelphia.
Okay, wow. Sorry for the length. I am going to try and shorten this on the next one, but sorry, for now you have to watch this long video. So basically, then took a while, but with 2 minutes and 10 seconds to go in the first period, which is 17 minutes and 10 seconds into the game, Bruins on a power play again. Lucic scores for his 11th on the season. Joe Corvo and Sagan, and Tyler Sagan.
Can't clear past Sagan. He chips the pass over the stick to Corvo. His blast scores! Milan Lucic in front with the tip in, and the Bruins are up 4-0 on Philadelphia in the first.
A few minutes later, huge save by Tim Thomas.
Voracek all the way up the rink, slides it in the middle for Yager. He drops it up to Simmons. Thomas with the rollover, stacking the pads, and then he gets shoved in the net. Voracek comes right into the crease, starts swinging, gets a Bruin leverage, and now he grabs a hold of Pavely, and Pavely is not too happy about that. He's going to say, why I oughta? Play is dead. As we've said before, it's the dead in the head. That's off the post as Thomas tries the whirly bird move. And then Philly just tries to ram it into the goal.
After that, no offense for a while. But, so not long after that, Johnny Boychuk and Scott Hartnell go for a fight. 17:48 into the period. They both get a 5-minute major. As well as Boychuk getting a game misconduct. Okay, so basically, yep, that happened. Second period recap. Horn scores, 7:06 in on the power play, assisted by Zdeno Chara for the Chara's Gordie Howe hat trick, also assisted by Rich Peverly, and 16:21 into period, Horton fights Ronaldo. Ronaldo gets a misconduct. Both get a 5-minute fighting major. Now ready of Horton's goal.
Firing save rebound. Horton scores. 5-0 Boston. Zdeno Chara with a Ray Bourque special. About 80 miles an hour. Low. Had to produce a rebound.
Beep. Attention. We ask the next 7,976 Flyers fans leave. This will make 9,970 Flyers fans out of the building singing jingle bells outside of the building. Yep. That didn't actually happen. Also, Horn's goal coming at 7:06 of the second. Horn's fight at 16:21 of the second. Lucic also got a 5-minute major and a 10-minute game misconduct. Then in the third, Sagan, And then third, Brad Marchand, 16:35 into the period, got a game misconduct. But then, a few minutes later, Philadelphia gets a two-minute penalty with a minute and 30 seconds to go. Also, before Marchand's penalty, Sagan scored at 12:12 in the third to make it a 6-0 win. To make it 6-0. Bees up 6-0.
Frosting on this cake. There's Sagan's shot. Scores! A big, huge slice to go and make it a six-pack.
And also, after Horton's goal, after Nathan Horton's goal that brought the Bruins up 5-0, Philadelphia pulled Elabizgalov, however you can say his name, for Sergei Bobrovsky, after Horton's goal because of performance. And so, that's what happened. And so it stayed that way. Bruins win 6-0 versus the Flyers. Oh, and here's an announcement after Sagan's goal. All remaining Flyers fans leave. All Bruins fans can stay. Yeah, so basically, the Philadelphia fans were not happy. Most of them had left by the time Sagan scored. And this game started at 1:07 and ended at 3:44. Puck drop was actually scheduled for 1:08. And Tim Thomas gets the win for the Bruins. And Elabizgalov got the loss for Philadelphia. And Philadelphia's empty net was 2 seconds. And the Bruins actually had 9 seconds due to delayed penalty. So the Bruins win this 1-6-0. A huge blowout of the Philadelphia Flyers on the road. The Flyers fans not pleased at all during this entire game.
Far side, it'll be 30 for 30. Tim Thomas gets his 30th career shutout, and the Boston Bruins, in 41 days, go from the very bottom to the very top of the Eastern Conference. There is your conference leading team.
Yep, shutout for Tim Thomas. So I hope you enjoyed the video. If you want me to improve anything, which I'm pretty sure I'm gonna get a huge set of comments, please leave them below. Last but not least, the three stars were number one, Tim Thomas, number two, Rich Peverly, and number three, Zdeno Chara. Those are the official NHL three stars, and they were all for the Bruins. So, thanks for watching, and